About 2 years ago, I had a visitation from two angels. I was in a season of soaking and just really pressing in for the deep things of God. I went to bed about 10 o'clock in the evening, and I was awakened at 11:22 by two angels blowing silver trumpets in my face. It was pretty incredible. There were two angels. One angel was on the left-hand side of me, and was literally blowing a trumpet in my left ear. It was a long silver trumpet. On the other side of me, on the other side of the bed, there was another angel with a long silver trumpet blowing the trumpet in my right ear. What came out of the trumpet of the angel on my right was a wind. And that wind actually went into my spirit, went down into my spirit man. And immediately I found myself being lifted up off of the bed, and just being lifted through the stratosphere, just watching everything go by, and found myself coming to rest in a place called the Room of Intercession. And I was watching as if it were, you know, from a third person point of view. I was watching myself laying in this Room of Intercession, and there were angels there, there were people there, and intercession was going on over the nations. And I was watching myself praying. And as I was watching myself praying, there was this spontaneous explosion of the presence of God. Just this incredible worship was coming out of my mouth. And I heard myself saying, and I'm watching myself saying, "Lord, you are so beautiful. You are so holy. You are so lovely. You are so awesome, God. You are so incredible." And this welling of emotion and welling of the Spirit of God was flowing out of me. And as I listened to myself speaking, I noticed that there were two voices coming out of me. One was my voice, but the other one was the voice of the Lord. And it was like harmoniously we were decreeing and declaring the goodness of God over the nations. It was an incredible encounter. I'd never had an encounter like this before. That encounter lasted a long period of time. I remember waking up the next day, and things had changed. We had somebody, an appointment, someone had come to our house, and the person walked into the house, and behind the person, there was an angel walking behind the person. So my eyes were really opened in a brand new dimension into the supernatural, just seeing the angelic realm. And shortly after that, we were already moving out in ministry, itinerant ministry, and just incredible things were taking place. I noticed immediately there was a brand new level of healing and miracles, and we were seeing creative miracles, and gold teeth started popping in our meetings, and all kinds of things. There was a brand new dimension of the glory of God. Literally, we had fireballs come into the meeting, and everybody that got near the fireball would get healed. This happened immediately after this visitation. One of the things that happened from these two angels was I was supposed to be in a conference in Cincinnati, Ohio, a conference called Engaging the Revelatory Realm of Heaven. And Rick Joyner was there, Patricia King was there, Jim Gall, and Paul Keith Davis. Well, it was supposed to start on a Thursday night, and I was to be there on a Thursday night, but I had a prior commitment, and I told the host pastors that I wasn't going to be able to be there on Thursday night, that I was going to come on Friday. Again, there were about 1,500 people in this conference. So I had my meeting on Thursday night, and I went to bed early, again, 10 o'clock, because the plan was for me to drive. It's only about a four-hour drive, four and a half, from Nashville, where I live. Go to bed at 10 o'clock, wake up, and drive to Cincinnati to be at this conference, which I did. I woke up at 1 o'clock, drove to Cincinnati, or actually it was 2 o'clock, drove to Cincinnati, and I got there early in the morning. Well, by the time I got into the conference, and everybody was in the conference already. I'm not sure who was speaking, so I went in and I signed the guest book, and no one was at the registration table. I signed my own name badge and I put it on, and I'm well known in that area. People know who I am, so I greeted people as I went in, and I found my place and I sat down. Well, we went through the whole conference that whole day, and by the end of the day, I was exhausted, and I found the host pastors, and they said, "Hey, Jeff, it's good to see you. I thought you weren't coming till today. We saw you last night." I said, "Yeah, well, I just kind of blew it off. You know, I wasn't sure what was going on. I was just kind of tired." I said, "No, I got here actually this morning, and, you know, I've been here. I drove through the night, and, you know, I got here in the morning, and I've been through the conference all day long, and I'm going to go back to the hotel, and I'm going to rest." And they looked at me with a kind of a puzzled, puzzled expression. They said, "What do you mean? You were here last night." I said, no, I wasn't here last night. I got here this morning, and I'm tired, and I'm going to go to the hotel, and I'm going to rest." And the guy that was emceeing the event was standing next to the host pastor. He said, "What do you mean you got here this morning? Don't you remember our conversation from last night? Don't you remember our conversation?" And he explained to me what we had talked about, and that I signed your name badge, and I put it on you, and we said this and said that. And come to find out, there were over 40 people at that conference that had that I'd ministered to on Thursday night, laid hands on, prophesied over, prayed for, and something took place. Something of a supernatural visitation took place because I was in Nashville on that Thursday night, and Friday, over 40 people saw me and had me minister, lay hands on them. So the big deal was at the conference, Jeff Jansen's angel showed up. Jeff Jansen's angel showed up at the Glory Encounters, or Engaging the Revelatory Realm of Heaven conference. So this was all on the heels of the visitation from the two angels. And I asked Bob Jones about it. I called him on the way home from the conference, and I said, "Bob, what's the deal?" And he said, "Jeff, these things are becoming common again." He said, "We've moved into a brand new place in the body of Christ, and we're going to start hearing about visitations and supernatural signs and wonders like this. You can call it a bilocation, two being in two places at one time." Bob had another theory, an idea of really what happened. Bob said, "This kind of thing used to happen to me in the 80s, where I would show up at a conference a day early." Actually, he said, "Viola and I would show up at a conference a day early, and we would get together with the pastors and tell the pastors everything that God is getting ready to do in the region." And then Bob said, "Then the next day we would show up, and the pastors would take us out for dinner, and the man that looked like me, they would tell me of the conversation of the man that looked like Bob from the previous day." Bob said, "Sometimes I'd tell him about it, sometimes I wouldn't." But I tell you, those are spiritual dimensions, and we need to get ready for greater spiritual dimensions. Transportations, translations, being in two places at one time, it doesn't matter. These are all normal and to be expected. And, like I said, Bob had another idea of what he thought the whole visitation was all about. But needless to say, it was a sign and it was a wonder. It was so much so stirring that, Rick Joyner wanted it documented. Paul Keith Davis wanted it documented. Some things went out on the Elijah List about it. And, I think Paul Keith actually did an article called A Modern Day Sign and Wonder. So get ready for new dimensions in the glory. And we need to get ready for new aspects, new dimensions, new levels in the glory. This is normal behavior for us as believers, not for Christians, but for us who believe all things are possible. So I'm really excited about it.